Welcome to this 20th session of Ergonomics for Beginners Industrial Design Perspective. Current module is module number 4, Posture and Movements. Out of the total 8 classes under this module, so today's module is today's session, there is a class number 20, Horizontal Work Surface. Now, gist of last class, where we mentioned that the arm reach, arc and vision guides easy to operate curved vertical work surfaces features, that is concave and convex. Now, like this, that from head height to waist height, the curved surface may be, when you are talking about concave surface, straight vertical, and thereafter above head and below waist, it may be inclined like this. The physical reach arcs passes through respective comfortable arm reaches of vertical, upper, middle, lower and lowest positions for erect and leaning forward postures, and also sideways and backwards. The frontal arc initially starting at around 15 degrees inward at around 200 millimeter overhead and below waist, it gradually nears the user head to waist may be straight vertical. The vertical plane of the visual field follows a stepwise curvature over the head and below the waist of approximately 5 degrees inward inclination at each 200 millimeter. Now, with this figure we have discussed, where with this curved work surface, it can be said the effective vertical work surface curvature above the head height and below the waist level, 10 degrees inward inclination at every 200 millimeter if we keep it, and the mid position length from head to the waist straight vertical. So, if we have a curvature of this type of, then we can say that it would be easier to touch and it will be good to see also. And the distance of that work surface would be around 1 to 1.5 meter, so that either standing erect or leaning forward or with a step, it would be easier to operate on that surface. So, with this, now today we are moving the today's topic, the class number 20 is that horizontal work surface. Now, if a person stand or sit, what is the horizontal work area he can work upon? Some facts that the basic fact of workstation design is that when a person stand, the square area and the height, it is inversely proportional. Like when he sits or squats, that area it comes and the height like this. Also, we require to consider the total arm span and the span akimbo, means folding arm at elbow, this distance, either in a sitting posture or standing posture, and then forward leaning or sideways and backwards also. Even in a squatting posture also the forward reach, even in a seated position the forward reach and how much you can touch, all these things are necessary to concern in this today's discussion. So, the total dimension that this matter we have discussed earlier, this human body dimension concept, and now we are going to discuss its workstation application. One example we can say that the Godrej is this furniture matter. Here it says that the units of workspace is made for two persons. Now, somewhere single person's workstation is also designed, somewhere many people can work together, and that type of workstation is also necessary to conserve. Now, some fact is that why we need to have two persons or single persons or three persons work unit. If we consider, suppose in a gathering party or something like that, it is observed that most of the groups are made by two persons, means they are moving in that place, but they are talking to each other. This type of groups are seen maximum for two persons. Now, another person, if they join third person, so that three persons group are relatively less, means what happens if some other persons comes closer to that, there is a chance to break this three persons group, and one person can go to some other area and can make another group of two or something like that. Four persons group are much lesser, and more than that is very few. So, considering this aspect, if perhaps this design is done for two persons to make a group. Now, the concern is that if these two persons are close enough, then it is good. Otherwise, what happens? There will be privacy problem. So, then what would be the total privacy feeling? Now, we can say that the arm reach front and sideways, the arm reach value is the physical demarcation of a person's total area he can work upon, but psychological territorial feeling, it depends on the task he is doing as well as the feeling he has for that task and the other people around him. For that purpose, in this case, if we can have a modesty panel like this, then it would be good. Now, if it is necessary, it can be placed. If it is not necessary, when we require a larger space, then this can be removed. So, now the concern is that what makes or what activity or what factors decides this dimension of this work surface on a horizontal platform. So, that we could discuss now. Now, another example is that stallion from Godrej, it has a single occupancy unit, but three single units are combined together to have a special unit, work unit. So, in this case, what happens? This person gets the privacy as well as all the dimensions here, the length, breadth, and the curvature of all these things, it matches the task as well as the person's requirement and psychological requirement as well as physical dimensions. Now, though it is seen that in a single work platform people are working, but still all the people, they are concentrating on their task independently. So, it rises a query that whether this unit for work unit for single person, two persons group or more, whether it would be modular or a single platform, all these questions come, and that needs to be answered with the context, specific context. Now, this is another work area where this person's work area is in such a position that is not comfortable. Why he is not comfortable? Because he has to attend something here for the mouse and keyboard, he is looking at that, and he also needs to concern with all these papers and etcetera. So, for seven, whether what will be the location of these work components on a horizontal surface, we need to concern with the body dimensions, movement of ranges, body and the arm, and the task requirement, and the placement of work equipment. In this is another figure we are showing here, that here the work area, the relatively personal work area and relatively general or common office area, where the person, the faculty member, the person can interact with others, that is separated. So, there are many concerns are there, how it behaves and how it we should look. Now, if we see this animation here, that the person moves, you see, in a standing erect, the total arm dimension here, the reach, bending and etcetera, it gives the basic clue for this workspace design. Now, here with this figure, if we see its schematic diagram, then we can say that the person here, he may stand or sit at normal at the elbow level or the shoulder to elbow in between, when he keeps the arms to this touching the palm over palm, this is that the span akimbo length, and when he spreads the arm, this is the span length. So, here the concern is, if the person can extend his arm, folded arm like this, this is around 300 to 450 millimeter, both the sides, and this one, the lengthwise, this is the span akimbo length. Now, here, this data is that the fifth percentile of this span length is 740 millimeter, average is 50th percentile, because that 850 millimeter, 90th percentile is 950 millimeter, and the span length also, it says that fifth percentile is that 1480 millimeter, 50th percentile 1660 millimeter, and 95th percentile 1810 millimeter. So, this much space one can cover with the arm reaches. Now, so with the span akimbo length and the total arm length in front, so this much space, this is the major work area is done here like this way. So, this depth, this area is the primary work zone where the maximum work is being carried out, is the primary work zone. Now, so this is the primary work zone. Now, one thing is that in that primary work zone, when we work something, at least we require some space to rest the palm. So, from body around 7 to 10 centimeter space, we cannot use it. It is specifically required for palm rest. So, this much space here we need to leave. So, this is the around 70 to 100 millimeter normally not in active use, that much space we need to keep free. So, keeping this much space free, this area, this whole area is the primary work zone. So, most important work where immediate attention is needed to write, read or to do some work, that would be placed within this area. And then maximum work area is that if we, when we expand our arm both the sides, this area is that total work area. So, this is the total horizontal workspace for a seated person. Now, if when he bends forward, then this is the arm length. When he bends sideways, then from the seat reference point, this is the length, and from the back side, this is the length. Now, all these arm lengths and etcetera are being centered at the seat reference point, SRP, seat reference point. What is the seat reference point? Now, if a person stand or if a person sits, then from the center of the head, take the straight axis where the two knees, if you take a line where the two knees are meeting in that axis, so that point is called seat reference point. So, from this workstation design etcetera, all the dimensions are being concerned with this seat reference point. Now, if we take one step forward, sideways or backward, then the total arm length, this is that maximum arm length is this one. So, this is that maximum arm reach with a step. So, this is that touch the third work zone. And beyond that, if we take two steps, then we are losing the central work attention. So, even either erect, sitting or standing, maximum we can touch with the arm, then bending, then with one step, still we can come back to the central work attention area and we can work. Beyond that, if we cross, then we will lose this attention of the center point. So, this work area, so first work area is that, this is called the first work area. So, this is that primary work zone, secondary work zone, this is the tertiary work zone, that is maximum reach zone, and beyond that is the out of reach zone. So, within this space, according to our requirement to handle the objects, we have to place. Now, for placing all the things, there are some principles concerned. So, these principles are, the workplace needs to be redesigned using these principles. Now, the functional layout of components in respect of user's position and functional ability. There are four principles. Like number one principle is that the importance, principle of importance. Now there are many work components. Now arrangement of the components in order to operational importance means for that this is the principle of importance wise we can arrange the work components. Number two is that frequency of use. Grouping of the components, specific work equipment nearer to the intended uses to be placed is the frequency of use. Number third is that functional, principle of functional. Grouping of similar components, specific controls and their reactors should be placed as close as possible. Legitimate link connections among these components and the user are to be established. And the fourth is that sequence of use principle. To work upon the all the components for a certain purpose while performing some tasks, providing similar sequence of pattern layout operation will be advantageous. So means if we arrange all the components in a specific way so that a sequence wise one after another we can operate and there will be sequence. So that is, so if we follow this principle then component layout will be like that. So, but for a specific purpose, all the principles work together to give a specific layout on a work surface, layout of the different components. So, now the physical aspects of users comprise the body itself. Human body structure, growth and function means the same work area one cannot use when body structure changes from young age to old age, growth and function wise, when the function deteriorates or means the ability deteriorates. So, modification has to be there. Differences in various adapted postures like to minimize biomechanical stress, to allow easy reach of limits, to allow ability to shift posture and the limitations of ranges of movement of body parts and biomechanics are necessary to consider when a design decision is made. So, with this, now we will discuss whatever the theory we mentioned right now with an example. Now, the example is that we are taking a vegetable vendor's example, vegetable vendor's cart. He is selling some vegetables and he has some other equipment with him to have this selling business, and on that cart how he can arrange the items according to these principles whatever we discussed right now, that is principle of importance, principles of frequency of use, principle of function and principle of sequence. Now see, the workplace design principles of component layout in different work zones. Primary work zone with this concern, secondary work zone with extended arm and tertiary work zone with a bent with one step. Taking the example of a vegetable vendor, the list of objects in his workshop, that is that work cart could be like number A is that he is selling potatoes, number B he is selling carrots, suppose we are assuming it. Then C is the pumpkin, larger size, he is carrying money box with him on that cart in a hidden area and he is using a weighing scale. So, he has A, B, C, D, E, 5 components he is using for a certain sale purpose. Now, applying the principles of component layout, that 4 principles, importance, frequency of use, function and sequence, and rating scale obtained from vendor, we get as we ask the vendors. Rating scale means importance wise, when we ask him that whether you require this potato is the more important for you or weighing scale is more important for you, like that way. So, with that we are asking that using 1 to 5 degree scale, means where his response, if he says that it is very high, then 5 point, if he says that ok, then 3 point, and very low, then 1 point, means 1 is very low, 2 is low, 3 is ok, 4 is high and 5 is very high. So, this is the response. Now, we are arranging it. Now, we asked the vendor and the grouping is that we asked that which one is the for importance point of view, which one is the maximum importance. He said that D means that money box for him is the maximum important. So, he ranked this a 5. Then next is the E, E is the weighing scale, it is next important. Then A is the potatoes, because mostly people buy potatoes. So, potato is the get the 3 point. Then B is that carrot 2 point and C is that pumpkin, because large size pumpkin and also pumpkin sales, suppose it is less in that context. So, he gave the number 1 rank. So, this is ranking is that from importance point of view. Then frequency of use point of view, while selling this, how frequently he uses all the components, it is almost same to the importance as per his views. He said that frequency of use, maximum he uses the money box, D is the money box, E next 4 point is for the weighing scale, then A is the potatoes 3, B is the carrot and 1 is the pumpkin. Then from function point of view, to perform this selling business, selling function, what is that? For him sale purpose, money box is the very important for the function part, because whatever he does, he may sell potato, he may sell pumpkin, carrot or whatever, but for each purpose, D, that is money box, is the maximum importance. And E is the next weighing scale, whatever he sells, weighing scale has to be used. And A, B, C, potato, carrot and pumpkin, from function point of view, they have the almost same value. Then from sequence point of view, sequence wise, for selling purpose, first he has to attend the carrot, a potato, carrot and pumpkin. Then he takes those things from the customers and then he weighs the thing. So, sequence of use, then number 4 point is for the E, means weighing scale, then he weighs that, and after that at the end he does the money business, that is the money box. So, for sequence of use for selling, this is the scale. So, this one is different. So, for different principles, the components or the group of components and their rating are different. Now, with this, the same thing is mentioned here, all these things just it is repeated. Now, with this, we can see that, and what we see from here, that if we count to the for D, D is 5, 5, 5 and 3, 5, 5, 5 and 3, so total 18 points. Then for E, E got 4, 4, 4, 4, like this way. So it got 16 points. Then A, 3, 3, 3 and 5, 3, 3, 3 and 5, so it is 14. Then for B, B means carrot, 2, 2, 3 and 5, 2, 2, 3, 5, this is 12 point. Then C is a pumpkin, that is a 10 point, 1, 1, 3 and 5, so 10 point. From this we can say that which one, hence to distribute D, E, D and E would fall in zone 1, means where he is very comfortable to work with the, so means span akimbo and then arm, this forearm length, this area is the primary work zone. Then A and B, A and B, next it may be in the number 2 zone, means where he can extend arm without bending, that area second zone. And third zone C, we can keep in the third zone. This means the money box and weighing scale lies in the primary zone of the seller, so that he can assess it quickly and no one else can assess it. Means customers doesn't have easy access, but the seller, he has easy access to that. So this is in combination of importance, frequency, function and sequence, all four principles of component layout. Potatoes and carrot, being popular commodities, are in zone 2, accessible to both the vendor as well as buyers for choosing and weighing. Pumpkins in the C with the 10 points here, being big and less sold, are in zone number 3, where they would not obstruct the vendor's activities much and can be accessible to the buyers for weighing. So by this way, this example, so the in this here, the greater the score, the more importance in layout, and accordingly the placement will be made. So this example, as we have seen here, in a vegetable cart for vendors and buyers convenience point of view, these similar things will be useful for any kind of workstation design in a horizontal place surface or in any work surface that come different work component layout and etcetera. So, based on the above, a cart can be designed from the viewpoint of vendor's ease of operation. Such study also could be done from the viewpoints of customers even, and both the needs are compared, is vendors and customers, and accordingly, and the final layout of the horizontal, a kidney shaped surface on the cart can be conceptualized. If need, appropriate curvatures on the surface may also be given to take care of ease of reach to various items on the surface. The kidney shaped area is like this, means that this is the person, this is the primary work zone, this is the second work zone, this is the third work zone, and outside, out of the reach. So, combining all means vendor's easiness and customer's easiness, if we can have a cart of this type of size, then with the vendor is here, then from all the sides, these people can approach him and he can weigh. So, here what happened, money box, weighing scale and etcetera can be kept here, and then potato, carrots and etc. can be kept like this, and pumpkins, as it is sold less, this may be placed in these areas. So this is the schematic work surface easy to operate from buyers and sellers both point of view. Now the desk system, chair and desk system. This is the seat, this is the work zone. Now if this chair and seat and the desk is a joint unit where you cannot separate it, then the maximum distance is still here, that is that 75th percentile of front leaning movement arm reach. This is around 1200 millimeter from the stomach distance, like this. With allowance, it may be till 1300 millimeter. This frontal work area is 300 millimeter, and then distance total will be 1.5 meter, so that with extension of arm they can reach both the sides. And if it is a detachable seat and desk, where if you stand, then that seat may go back at that point from this table edge, around 1 meter gap is necessary, it will facilitate the backward clearance value. Now, with this, in this case, what happens? The work zones or work areas are totally separated. Means this is the personal work area and this is the meeting work area, but the same chair can be used for both the things, both the purposes. This chair with a swiveling wheel and etc., it may cross if it is necessary. Here the total work identity is different. Now this is a schematic presentation here, where if a person sits here like this, then this work area, primary work area, he can work, this is the secondary work area, and like this. This side, if he keeps his computer and etc. or personal work area, then the total maximum work area will be within his primary work zone. If he turns his head this type, this side he turns his head. The office work and etc., with out tray, in tray, etc., it may be kept here, so that on the tertiary work zone area. Here the furnitures can be placed so that the visitors can come here, and just changing his position, this person can take this side and can make this as a meeting place, and back side, if it takes turn, this is his personal belongings place and etc. So by this way, a the single user's workstation can be designed. So human body structure, benefits and limitations, and its design relevance. Man occupies a specific space to his own body form, size and shape, and when he moves, the space also moves with him. When he adopts different postures, the same body space changes accordingly. Differences between space occupied by an inanimate object and the man are that the human space is not only fixed, which the body physically occupies, but it needs some additional space and this varies from task to task, even person to person, and also differs according to body proportions of an individual. This additional space requirement is clearance value. Like here, when these persons are sitting, suppose this is a dining table kind of thing, when this person is sitting, for him this is the primary work zone area, for him this is, for him this one, for this person this one, for this person this one, like this way. So, there is no space for this person to occupy, he requires this much space. So, this space is overlapped by this 3 persons. So, what would be the clearance for this nowadays dining tables and workspaces and then some meeting surfaces are more or less oval shape to overcome this problem. Front working space clearance should be in line with the primary work zone. Overlapping of primary work zones at the corners of the table creates problems. So, this type of solutions one can think of. Based on this, this type of furnitures are available, designed, developed and available in market. So, here all those clearance values and etcetera are taken care of. Like this. Here the space is clearly mentioned, so that even sometimes with some color differences it is made it clear that how to use this work surface. Means 2 persons can sit this side, 2 persons can sit this side, 1 person this side, 1 person this side, like that. 2 persons here, 2 persons here, like that, maximum can be used. Whatever earlier said, this is the thing that if a person sits here, then this may be used for meeting place, for personal work area, immediate work area, this is the general office or general table, and these are the personal or maybe some storage where he does not require to attend always, for that some free space is given here for easy access. Free space is given here to get free access. So, this is the circulation allowance to be added. Here one thing is that this example has been taken from the Naval Station Rotor Spain Clinic case study, the prosthesis labs. In this it is said that when a person is working, he is working on the work surface, but his her elbows are hanging. She requires elbow rest. Now, if elbow rest is there, then he cannot work close. The same case also seen here. So, for that a special development is there, if we can have an additional arm rest, means that elbow rest. Now, that elbow rest is can be given either on the chair arm rest itself, or it may be on this works table on this extension. Now, the question comes that if we have a rest attached to this chair arm rest, then when we go back, then this arm rest also will go back. So, the central attention to the work, central work area, we cannot maintain. So, the hand will go back with the body, or we have to extend our hand. So, for this it is said that if it is an extension or additional to this work surface like this, then what's happen? He may change his body position, front or back, but this arm rest will remain same. So, this schematically we can say that this is the figure here, that then addition is given here. So, it will be used for arm rest, and the person can go inside, but with this arm rest he can work upon this. So, this is the extension of work area where the we are properly utilizing the primary work zone. Now, one query comes in. We have discussed this with a office work area, we have discussed with a different standing and sitting posture, even the same arm reach values and etcetera to be considered when we work on a squatting posture or sitting with a cross legged position on the floor, that reach values etcetera should be considered, the primary work zone, secondary work zone, tertiary work zone, all may be considered. The in all the postures, means sitting on floor or in a seat desk position or in a standing position. Now, one real life photograph is shown here. Now, we need to consider how all those component layout principles and other concerns what we discussed can assist this vendor and this buyer. This vendor is selling, he has to get reach here, buyer though he is sitting this fish baskets are displayed at very low height position. So, the person has to bend and select the fish like this. So, what so if we want to develop a specific workstation for this purpose, how it can be developed, how it can be done. So, with that challenge, we are concluding today's session with some thoughts. Most of the musculoskeletal disorders and some other occupational health problems are due to bad postures adopted while working as well as in one's daily life. The more one neglects this, the more one has to suffer and it becomes a chronic problem. The most of the common work surfaces are horizontal and in some cases vertical or slanting in various degrees, and in combination of all these types are seen in daily life. On horizontal work surfaces, the nature and importance of work, the attention to be given to the task, the layout with arm reach limits, well defined work zones or areas should be specified. The primary work zone of a single person working at a table should be considered for reading, writing, etcetera. For normal sitting clearances in sitting arrangements in a row, the same may be considered. Horizontal work surface may have an upward slope of 0 to 15 degrees and sometimes different heights also. All the data concern we may measure ourselves, or this some human data also available from this resource. From this source data can be available, ready available book. The measuring procedure, the person has to sit or we make a mock up simulation models and then measure directly with anthropometric sets or take the videography, photography and analyze all the things. So, with this we are concluding today's session. That is that horizontal work surface and concerns, and next session would be the class 21, that is movement and the posture and support, design support requirements for that. So, with this we are concluding the today's session. So, thank you very much.